Great, a dark background. That doesn't seem like a grid background though. The reason why it doesn't is likely because the line colors are either transparent or the same color as its background. So we are going to have to update that by using style sheets. Let's start by creating our style sheet. In Unity, make sure you are in the Assets folder and create a new folder named Editor Default Resources. Make sure you include the spaces. Inside that folder, we'll create another folder named Dialog System, just so it doesn't conflict with other people's folders if we ever use this as a package. Inside, we'll create a new style sheet by right-clicking in the project window, going to Create, UI Toolkit, and Style Sheet. I'll name it DS Graph View Styles. Inside our USS file, feel free to remove the default visual element selector, and instead type in grid background. We will be updating 4 things in our grid background: the background color, the line color, the thick line color, and the spacing between each line. Thankfully for us, Unity already provides custom properties that allow us to change that. Let's start with the background color by typing in dash dash grid background color, and pass in an Xcode which I already have some prepared, so feel free to copy them out. For this one, I'll be using 2b2b2b. The styles will not update themselves until we load and add a style sheet, so I'll be showing the differences in the screen. For our line color, we use the property line color, and I'll pass in an RGBA this time, so I'm going to make it the same color as the thick line color, but with some transparency. So RGBA, and I'll pass in 51, 51, 51, and an alpha of 0.4. For our thick line color, we use thick line color, and I'll pass in the same value as our line color, but with an alpha of 1. You could also simply pass in RGB instead without specifying the alpha, but just in case you want to make the alpha lower than 1, you can leave it as is. And last but not least, we have our line spacing. The higher the number you type, the bigger your grid squares will look like. So type in spacing, and I'll give it a value of 25. You do not need to specify that in pixels or anything, simply type in the number that you want. Our styles are done, so it's time for us to load our style sheet and add it to our graph view. So let's head back to our graph view script and create a new method called addStyles. Inside, we'll be loading our style sheet using the editor GUI utility load method. To do so, create a variable of type style sheet and I'll name it style sheet. I'll load it by typing in editor-gui-utility.load. If this class isn't recognized, simply import its namespace. Then type in the path of the style sheet in here. When we are done doing that, we need to add the style sheet to the style sheets variable. Because GraphView ends up inheriting from Visual Element, we can simply type in style sheets dot add and pass in our style sheet variable. Do not forget that in path we need the dialog systems folder as well. We do not, however, need to type in the editor default resources folder name. If we go back to Unity, we shall now see our grid background updated with its new styles. That's enough, but we shall probably start by creating our style sheet variables. In the grid's case, I'm not going to use these colors anywhere else because it's a different color theme than the rest of the dialog system, so that it looks more like the default styles, but it's always nice to have them there in case we need them for usability, or just update them through one file. So let's go back to our dialog system folder in the editor default resources folder and create a new style sheet. I'll name this one DS Variables. As the name states, we'll be adding every style variable here. We need to start by typing in our root pseudo class selector, and then declare our variables inside. I'll be following Unity naming of it, but because it's my first time doing that, it might not be 100% correct. I'll have a link down below if you want to know more about how Unity names their stuff. I'll start by adding ds at the beginning of every variable to specify it's a variable that I made for this dialog system. Then the type of the style, such as colors or metrics, followed by the scope, such as grid or window, or a certain element. I'll be using window for anything that can be used by every element in our window. Then the style value, such as 20 pixels or just 25. In case it is in pixels, I'll add it before the value, such as pixels 25. For colors, I'll be doing something like dark gray or light gray. Then the number in case I have multiple of the same value, such as dark gray 1 and dark gray 2. This is because I find it a bit hard to name colors as they are all shades of gray. So what I'll do is order them from darker to lighter, darker being 1 and lighter being n. In this series, I'll be separating the scope in grid and window. This is the only time I'm going to use a grid scope, so feel free to set it as window if you'd like, or just name them however you'd like. Let's start things off by creating our darkest color by typing in ds colors grid light gray 1 and pass in 2v2v2v. Then we'll create ds colors grid light gray 2 for our line color, which is RGBA 51 51 51 0.4. For our last color, we'll type in ds colors grid light gray 3 and pass in the same RGBA values but with an alpha of 1. For our spacing, we'll go with ds matrix grid 25 and pass in the value of 25. We have our variables done, so all we need to do now is to swap them in our USS file. So open up the GraphView styles file and update the values to use the new variables using the var function. If we save and go to Unity, the window might still have your styles, but if you reopen the window, it will no longer have them. That's because we need to load our variable stylesheet, and we'll do that in our editor window. So head back to the editor window script and create a new method in the onEnable method called addStyles. In here, we'll copy the code from our GraphView addStyles method and paste it in. We'll simply update the path to be ds variables instead. We'll also need to make sure we are adding the style to the root visual element, as the editor window isn't a visual element itself. Saving and going back to Unity, we shall now have our styles working no matter how many times we reopen the window.